Dr. Rakesh sir, he is my favorite teacher in Marrow, and almost every subject I liked it a lot in Marrow. Surgery Rohan Khandelwal sir and microbiology Dr. Shivika ma'am. Every one of them, I want to name each and every subject, and I liked the way they teach, and my concepts have built very strong because of Marrow. I have also joined the AIIMS TND from dance, but my primary source was Marrow. I like the way Dr. Rakesh sir teaches. It gives an overall idea. He teaches anatomy, he teaches physiology, and he teaches medicine, pharmacology, everything in one place. So that will give a very overall idea, integrated approach. I liked his approach, and he always tells cases, clinical cases, correlating with the topic that he is teaching. In every video, he tells a case and how he has dealt with that case, what are the mistakes that he have done. And I love medicine and I love to learn more. And if the way he teaches clinically as a patient-oriented approach, that helped me a lot. Sakshi Arora ma'am's videos, I have watched almost all of them. My OB-GYN preparation was entirely what ma'am taught, and it was more than enough. So it gives a very good overall picture and very good notes. Hi everyone, this is Dr. Vinita. I'm very happy to come here and speak to all the aspirants, PG aspirants, regarding my journey. Today I'm very happy that I have achieved rank 1 in AIIMS exam. I'm from Guntur, Andhra Pradesh. I completed my undergraduation in AIIMS Bhubaneswar. I have used Marrow Plan C. I would like to talk about my journey through Marrow and how I prepared to get this result. When I started my internship, I took Marrow Plan C. I did not go for any classroom coaching before that, in third year or fourth year. So Marrow was my primary source of preparation. So I have started with Plan C. I've used some of the videos during internship, but I could not watch many of the videos in internship as there was work also, and I have to go. I have to prepare along with my work. So I watched some of the videos in medicine. I have given November AIIMS and PGI, and I secured 1,118 odd rank in AIIMS. I could not complete the paper in November AIIMS exam. I left like around 7 to 10 questions. So I knew I could not get a good rank, but I worked on that problem. I worked to manage time properly. So that's very important. You have to complete the paper if you have to be in the competition. Then PGI November, I got a good rank, rank 45 in PGI November, but I could not get a general medicine seat. PGI is a very good college, so everyone told me that you can take pediatric seat in PGI. Pediatrics is the closest thing to medicine, but I like medicine and I didn't want to compromise on the institute just because it is a very famous institute. I didn't want to compromise on my dream. So if I got rank 45 without the perfect preparation, I know I did not give my fullest in November exam because there was very little time, and I have started preparation only in internship, and I didn't have any notes that I made. So I knew that I did not give my full efforts. So I thought if I could get 45 rank in PGI November exam with very little preparation, then if I prepare well for 6 months, I can definitely get my dream branch. Marrow videos are very good, but if you are in internship, I would suggest that you can watch some topic wise videos. You know, you take a grand test, you will know what subjects you are weak in. Then you start with those subjects. You watch videos selectively. Maybe you'll already have an idea from the previous exams or from your seniors what topics are generally being asked. So select those topics, read it. Don't try to complete a subject 100%. You will not be able to do that. There will definitely be some new question how much ever you read. So don't get disappointed by that. You can never complete a subject 100%. Medicine is very vast. there is always new things coming up. So you have to do how much you can, and whatever you do, you have to be very thorough with it. The basic thing to the Central Institute exams is the concept. You have to be very strong in your concepts, then you can answer any type of questions, whatever the pattern. Surgery, I think if you can watch or read the notes of Dr. Rohan Khandelwal's, or even DAM, or even anything, if you have attended classroom coaching of DAMS or Bhatia, anything, surgery, if you can go through the notes. And surgery, the main thing is you have to keep doing the questions, because what I feel is surgery is not like if you read once, you can answer all the questions. They will ask you the approach. Suppose a breast cancer patient, the questions on breast cancer will be like, they will give you a case just as you see in a clinic, like just as you see in your OPDs. They will ask you the TNM staging, or they will even give you the TNM staging and tell you, ask you what you will do further, investigations or management. So that you will get. See, if I read today about breast cancer, I'm not practicing it in my daily routine, so I will not remember it after 1 week. So the key in surgery is you have to do questions. OB also, you have to do questions, because especially OB, gynae is mainly, you can remember most of it, gynae, if you read once, that is okay. But OB, you have to do questions, because that will be a little bit tricky. You can get confused between two options. See, when you are preparing initially, your goal should be to cover all the subjects and most of the topics, not the entire subject. You will not be able to do that. The main topics, the important topics for the exam, most of the subject, overall idea of the subject, and some questions and your mistakes, you have to keep on revising them. When your preparation is done, what will happen is, when you're doing grand tests, you know the answer to the question, but you will get confused between two options. That is where you get many questions wrong. So that confusion between two options, if that should go, then you should practice questions and you should strengthen your concept. Suppose you have done one question wrong, don't memorize the answer. You will not get anything out of it. So you have to go back and see that topic. No matter, you may not remember that. So you see the topic repeatedly. You should know what topics you are going wrong, not the questions and memorizing the answers. So that's how it will help you. The clinical subjects, if there are clinical questions, one thing for internship people, you have to attend your clinics. Even for third and fourth year students, you have to attend your clinics. That's very important, especially for AIIMS. This time there were very few, actually no videos, and image-based questions also very few, and all of them were single best response questions. But I think in November, again, the pattern will change to the new pattern of questions that AIIMS has started, like extended matching and match the following, sequence-based questions, true or false, and all those. Especially extended matching questions, they give you a case and they give you lot many options. So you have to, the question is easy. If you can solve the case, then you will automatically come to the answer. So what is the key here? You have to attend your clinics. And internship people, observe every procedure that you're doing. Don't take it lightly. And AIIMS asks very simple questions that you do routinely, like intubation. You see routinely, even if you don't do an internship, you see that routinely. And intubation, pap smear, questions like these are not supposed to be, you should not get wrong. So when will you not get wrong? You are seeing that daily as a routine. So that will be in your mind. You need not read these questions, like gloves, how to hand wash, how to don and doff of PPE, all those questions. So these are things that you learn by seeing and doing. So concentrate on that. It's not that you skip your postings and sit in your room and study, do MCQs. That will not get you anywhere. You have to attend your classes, you have to attend your postings. Everything is important. And what has got me this rank and to this stage is I have been like consistent from first year. Whatever I'm learning, I may not remember what I have read in first year, but if I read again once, then I will definitely grasp it quicker. because I have developed that concept earlier itself. So that's very important. And coming back to this subject wise, then pediatrics, there were not many questions, but the few questions are on neonatology. For AIIMS, neonatology is important. Marrow neonatology, I have watched the episode, the videos. So you can use the Marrow Q Bank. You cannot watch all the subjects, all the videos in Marrow. There are too many videos if you are starting late. Like I started in internship, there is no time for me to watch all the videos. I have watched most of the videos of subjects that I felt that I need more better concept. So you can do that. But if you are having little time, like now people who are preparing for the November AIIMS exam, mainly the interns, you will have very little time because you are working. So you read from whatever notes you have and you do the questions from, if you are using Marrow, from Marrow Q Bank or whatever Q Bank you are using. Marrow is the one that I used to get seat in November also. I got 45 rank in PGI in November. That time my only source was Marrow. So Marrow is the one that helped me a lot. No doubt there is, I took some help from DAMS also, because that is also a very good coaching institute. Those who are taking DAMS, take your notes well and attend your TND sessions. And those are also very helpful. Whatever it is, stick to one thing. You can't use too many resources. Marrow, I can talk more about Marrow because I used it a lot. Marrow Q Bank, I found it very useful because the explanations are very good. Doing a question like grand test or mini test or whatever subject wise test that I do, I can revise that test in the same amount of time that I have taken to give the test. I need not watch another video for its discussion. All the explanation will be in that question explanation itself. So Marrow Q Bank explanations are very good. Questions are standard. Questions did come from Marrow Q Bank. Even in last November AIIMS, I remember there were questions from Marrow Q Bank. I am not telling you should do the entire Q Bank. That's Q Bank also you have to prioritize. Everything that you prepare, you have to prioritize based on the time you have. You have to cover the major topic in Q Bank. You take topic wise and do the topics that you are. Suppose you are doing a grand test and you have got too many questions wrong in OB-GYN, you take OBG and you do the questions from question bank. That will help you revise. What is the difference between reading it again for revision and doing question bank is very important. I will prefer doing question bank because if I see a question and try to mark it, though I don't remember it, it will try to form more connections in my brain. I have read it somewhere, so I'll definitely remember something about it. If not the exact, I may not be able to come to the exact answer, but I will remember something about it and maybe I'll get confused between two options. Then I will go back and read in the explanation. But if you are reading notes again and again, you cannot have that, you cannot recall. You are just reading it again and again. It will be passive. So you have to actively recall. That will help in revision. Then custom module in Marrow is very nice. I have used custom module like many times for, I used to select the questions that I have done wrong or unattempted questions or anything. Suppose I want to revise ENT today, I used to just select some 10 questions and do 10 questions on ENT. From it will come from here and there. So from Q Bank and grand test and everything that I have done wrong, I can just go through that. You can use that also. That's a very good feature. And coming to the other topics in Marrow, I like very much medicine videos mainly and surgery and OBG. So the clinical subjects are important for every exam. You get around 25 to 30 questions from medicine and 20 to 25 questions from surgery and OB-GYN. And Marrow medicine, the main thing is it not only answers the questions from medicine, but it also helps me to answer the questions from physiology, from pathology, because the teaching is integrated. Giving grand tests is very important. Don't spend too much time on reading and making notes. And you can take time. See, if you are in fourth year, you take your own time to make your notes, watch videos, strengthen your concepts. But if you are in internship and if you are planning to crack the exam in November, this will not be a good idea for them to keep watching the videos. So you have to rely more on solving the questions. You can do question banks topic wise and grand tests. I would like to talk about the grand tests. They're very important. It is very important to give grand tests. You should give grand tests like at least 2 grand tests in a month, or whenever the grand test comes live, you can give the grand test, so that you'll get the rank and you'll know the competition. I have given all the grand tests according to the schedule of Marrow, and I got good ranks in grand tests also. That gave me a hope that I will do well. Previously, when I was preparing for November exam, my grand test ranks were somewhere between 400 to 500, sometimes even around 900 also. It was somewhere around 1000. Okay, sometimes I used to get even like 2000, 3000 also. But this time it was very consistent. My grand test ranks were below 50, all of them, up to 4 grand tests that I have done. I got rank 8 in Marrow AIIMS mock. But that did not mean to me that I'm going to get below 10 in final exam. I just thought, okay, I'm doing well. I should keep this consistency and do well in the final exam also. The final exam is that matters. You should not be overconfident before the exam, and don't think of the result before it comes. I gave the exam very cool, and before going to AIIMS exam, this was on my mind. Because I was very anxious in this corona time, pandemic, and all this stuff, it led to a lot of anxiety. And I thought, I have given 6 months, even though I had an opportunity to take a seat, very good seat in PGH Chandigarh last time. So I should not waste this. I have prepared well. I am doing good in the Marrow grand tests. And Marrow grand tests are quite standard tests. I did not get the same ranks last time, even though I did well in the final exam. So this time I'm doing well even in the grand test, so maybe I have a good chance. So there is nothing to get low. You just have to stay calm, and time management is the key. You have to keep going. If you are stuck at a question and you spend like 1.5 to 2 minutes at a question, then like, if it is one question, then that is okay, but you have to keep an eye on the watch, on the timer that is going on. You should not spend too much time on a question, because there will be some tough questions. You may think that I can get the answer to this question, but it is taking time. You'll just kill your time for the other questions. So you should not do that. Just skip and go away. If you are skipping, you'll definitely have time in the end. If you don't skip, you will not have time in the end. Not only you are putting so much time for this question which you may or may not get right, and you are losing many questions in the end. So if you skip that question, you'll definitely have time to come back to that question. So time management is the key. Don't miss the questions. And grand tests and QBank, so as many questions as you solve, that will give you an advantage in time and managing time, and also it will improve your accuracy. Never compare with another person in your grand test. You compare with your previous grand test with your own performance. You should be improving on your own performance, no matter how other people are doing. I am very grateful to my parents. I owe all of this success to them, to my mother, to my father, to my brother, and to my late grandmother. I would like to introduce my parents. During this corona time, they have helped me a lot, supported me.
Thank you for your guidance through Marrow. It is very much useful to my daughter, and she likes Marrow coaching.
I would like to wish all the best for all my juniors who are preparing for the November exams, AIIMS, PGI, JIPMER, and you'll all do well. I know everyone has this capability in you. You just have to believe in yourself, prepare well, build your concepts, think that you're studying for the day when you are the only person between your patient and his life. So not just for this exam, do well. All of you can achieve this, what I have achieved. It's just based on hard work, and you have to keep going. There are times when you get disappointed, but you just have to keep going.